Heading up to get my Titan tank from Idaho Falls, Idaho. It'll be a fun little road trip. Beautiful Idaho Falls. All right, our Titan distributor got some in from Michigan.
Minnesota. Maple Plain, Minnesota.
It's in the back. Can you see it? Check it out. I've got a Titan hat.
It's a Wendy's Baconator.
Oh, yes, hungry.
That's a big tank. Just raise the back end of the truck. Tells me to look inside for any foreign debris. No, no debris. There we go. That's what I need to remove from the truck. Disconnect the fuel gauge, electrical connection, and the feed line return line from the sending unit. Okay, so I'm just gonna use a motorcycle tie down strap and strap that underneath the tank to support it there while I'm pulling off the front strap because I don't want it to just fall away. Cool. Full strap. That won't be necessary. The tank is now supported almost entirely by the back strap. I'm going to go ahead and take that back strap off, support it with another one of these, and then just lower that enough so I've got plenty of access to the fuel lines and the electrical disconnects. Okay, got some weight on the strap there. See, now that thing is just floating free. I think all I have to do is just lower it enough so it's comfortable to get up there in those fuel disconnect lines, and then it should be free. I'll take the rest of the strap off right now. I'm going to lower the front a little bit. Got my knees under there. Kind of helping it down a little. There we go. Lots more room to work with. Now I can see what I'm doing. Okay, here we go. One thing's a little tricky. You gotta pull this out and push that in and you pull it straight up. We're just gonna let it down. All right, I'm starting to let it down, but there's no way that's going to go over the top of that frame. I'll bet if I read the instructions, it'll tell me to disconnect it from the tank right now. Tank is completely free. Now I'll just lower it to the ground. Good thing there's only about, 3 or 4 gallons
in there.
Okay, now I need to remove the hold down ring. Just like that. Okay, let's put that in the new one. Okay, they say to make sure that the orientation of this tab is the same as the orientation on the original tank. Torque them to 20 foot-pounds. Okay, there we go. Now we take off some of this sheath. That's a little bit nicer. Gotta cut this at 4.5 inches. I placed a mark there so we can install this vacuum vent. Something a little scary about cutting into a perfectly good hose. Go like that. I just realized something. The photograph shows that I should have removed it here instead of up there. So what I'll do is, I'll go ahead and disconnect these hoses, reinstall the spout on the truck, and then that'll get us back online with the way it should be done. Okay, cool. I'll go put that back on the truck. Okay, we're gonna put that on there. This on there. I'll screw them down. Okay, so I think this is how things are supposed to look when we're putting them back up in there. So this will just have to go up over the frame. It'll connect back into the spout. And this gets run up along the top as a vent. Boy, that's big. Making the connections up there are really, really tight. So you just kind of have to muscle your hand up in there, and it can do it all by feel. Unfortunately, the connectors are all just click on with a little positive lock. So I'm just going to go ahead and put the straps on the tank and then connect up the fuel spout and the vent lines and breathers, and we should be done. Last thing is to put together the front tank support. This would be quite unsupported without having something. And this is meant to go over the frame. We're gonna take that bolt out, put this here. This comes together and then bolts up there. So we'll try that. I gotta get that bolt out of there. Okay, I'm gonna put 10 gallons of ULSD in it. I started it up. And I had this big flashing message there that said fuel level low. Now I put 10 gallons in it, which is almost half of a normal fill up for me. Now look where the gauge is. So I'm gonna go get some gas. We're in new territory. Now remember, I started with 10 gallons. The guy behind me is waiting.
Plus 8. 0.773 plus 31.556. 50.329 gallon. That's cool. Here's what it looks like. All right, for those of you who are hesitant about being able to do that, come on, if I can do it, you can do it. It's not that big of a deal.